Identify the problem.
That's right. Be the solution.
The solution I am.
MyLifeInTrustFoundation.org.
Honestly, it is up to us to determine who actually has our best interests at heart. What we intend to do is to look out for our community with real issues and real thoughts. We want to be able to cover things that matter to our community. We want to be able to bring you this information without censure or without any form of restriction. We want to be the voice of our community and lead the charge for information that is disseminated throughout our masses.
The all-new MyLifeNewsNetwork.com with programming and news relevant to you. About us, for us, by us. MyLifeNewsNetwork.com.
Hey, this is Sean Fresh. I'm here with Rodney Perry. Y'all are now watching My Life News Network. Is that what that's proper, right?
You said it right.
I think I did.
But you kind of stumbled across the end. You want to say it one more time?
Hey, what's going on, man? This is Sean Fresh. I'm here with Rodney Perry. You are now watching My News. What's the last?
My Life News Network.
My Life News Network.
Start over. Yeah, I said,
what is happening? More this your boy.
Okay.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? This your boy, Sean Fresh. Government
Perry,
name,
baby.
Rodney Perry. Now, what was that name?
My Life News Network.
You are now watching My Life News Network.
They can use that one.
Hey, should I say that? I got to make it clean. God bless you.
Back out of here.
I got sisters and brothers to feed.
Ooh.
They ain't
coming
out like
no
weed.
Did a lot. bitch just lived
stop, stop.
And tell
her. Y'all don't know the words either, do y'all? I know the old people going like, what he saying? We don't know either. But men in the timid, nimmin, I'm in the wrong business, I know that. This is a hit record, dog. We in the wrong business. What you do for a living? You sell cars. This motherfucker got $1 million last year for this bullshit. It's men in the timid, nimmin. He got a hit record with no vowels. All consonants. I see the ladies came out tonight. Give yourself a hand, ladies. What's up? Okay, okay. What's up, homeboy? I see you roll down the aisle. Why, man? He did roll. He know he rolling. Anytime I see people with what is a perceived deficiency, you got to know God don't make no mistakes. You know what I mean? And he might be faking. He might be like, yeah, I got you. And y'all don't even know. But then, and then God is a God of balance. You think God put that man in a wheelchair and not keep it real hard? Ask him. Y'all be walking past him like, yeah, whatever, bitch, yeah. All that leg blood is good blood, yeah. You better ask somebody. Of these able-bodied dudes, you better get to rolling. You better goddamn get to rolling. If you with somebody you care about, make some noise tonight. That's you right there. Boom. I see you, big dog. Couples. Okay. Now hold on, wait. Did you authorize this outfit? These fishnets? He love this. I don't know. You ain't asked him, did you? He's like, baby, this is cute. What'd he say? No, he didn't, because he can't get a word in, because I can't. he ain't got a word in. How long y'all been together? 3 years? Yeah, he just gave up talking 2 years ago. He's like, okay, she gonna just, okay. Tell him, baby. Tell him I want what I want. Tell him. This is gonna be a good night. I can tell already. Is this your young lady? This your lady friend right here, sir? Y'all look cute together. Mm-hmm. How long y'all been together? 4 years. Okay. You be tearing it up. You look like Lucius from Empire. Come on now, Cookie. Oh, we got some white people to snuck in. Hey, white people. Welcome. They tried to blend in. I thought they was light-skinned at first, but they I'm like, no, I think that's white people. Okay. I see what's going on. She holding on that black man, that black king. Yeah, no, let him go now. Yeah, we know what y'all doing. That's beautiful. Y'all get a man, because who you love is who you love. You know what I mean? Who you love is who you love. Am I right, bro? You know what I'm saying? Is that your wife? Okay, stop. He looked at her like, Ixnay on the ice way. She did the same thing. Oh. What you going to do with that picture? What you gonna do with that picture? You gonna Facebook it? Did you get a good one? Cause I'll be still. Let me be still. Cause y'all put up a fucked up blurry picture in a minute. Let me be still. Hold on. That's good. Give her a hand. Now you can put it down. We gonna have some fun tonight. What's going on right here? Where you at? Huh? Oh, this brother-in-law, this your sister? Okay, brother-in-law, he be tearing that thing up, huh? He like, yeah, that's your, you know she doing it though, right? Oh, yeah. I'm a brother too. Don't nobody like to think about their sister being violated, but that big motherfucker back there, you know he destroyed all this right here, yeah. destruction, terror, and mayhem. Pass me a sissy and a sucker, I'll slay him, farmers. People don't want the truth. What about you, sir? Is that your wife? How many years? 4 years. Everybody 4 years in law. So y'all still doing it? Ma'am, we ain't got time for y'all. 4 years married? Yeah, that's good stuff, man. Y'all still do it? I mean, like, how many times a week? Don't answer that. Don't answer that. She like, please don't answer that. Please. That ain't none of their business. I'm married. Me and my wife just celebrated our 18-year anniversary, y'all. Give us a hand. 18 years. My wife be worried. She think I'm going to meet a woman at one of these shows and run off. I be telling her I ain't going no damn way. First of all, I can't spring this body on no new chick. I'm okay with clothes on, but naked. It's some bullshit up here, you know what I mean? I know I ain't all that. Look, I'm sweating. I ain't even start moving yet. Think I'm going to meet some woman and run off? I ain't going nowhere. Big, just sneak up on you, know the fellas? I just found out I was big last week. Anybody? Matter of fact, big dudes, make noise. Big dudes? Yeah. Just me and the DJ? Really? Come on. Come on, Pastor. You right here. Yeah, another right there. You know what it is, ladies? Big men don't know they big, do they? Like a woman is totally different. Woman be like, you know what? I ain't what I used to be, but I'm comfortable with who I am. Now the man, all the man do is slap his stomach and talk shit. Yep, all I got to do is get back in the gym. No, you can't get back in the gym because your mind still think you're sexy. You ever try to get back in the gym? You try to do all the workout the first day. You're like, I'm about to lose 100 pounds. Next day, you in pain. Ah! Baby, I need you to help me wipe my ass again. Speaking of wiping, I don't know why women ever get with us. Let me tell you something, ladies. Y'all are so generous. I mean, as women, y'all are beautiful human beings. I don't know why y'all ever get with us. Because let me tell you something. Look around the room. There's some good men in here. Good, up quality citizens, business owners, pastors, drug dealers. We got all walks of life. But one thing they all got in common, Dookie stains. Yeah. There's somebody here right now that wiped good today. Sitting on the edge of that chair, god damn. I cannot believe my ass is itching like this. You ever had to rewipe? You boo-boo, but you gotta go, man, I gotta do this again. Whoa, look at that. She looked away. She like, uh-uh. We nasty. Y'all put up. Anybody not allowed to wear white underwear? Anybody? Not allowed. Fellas, any man not allowed to wear white underwear? My wife banned them bitches like 10 years ago. I remember when she did it. Langston. I was out. I came back home. She holding my underwear at the door like, what the fuck is this? What are you eating, Snickers? She was so mad at me. So we can't do this no more. This the thing though. If you're a big guy, women like a big man. Cause they want to feel safe. Big man make you feel safe, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I don't know why I pointed to him, but you know, it just felt good. Make you feel safe. This is the thing though, fellas. If you big, ain't no clothes you could wear to make you look smaller. If you big, you just big. You can't go get no damn outfit. Stripes or some shit make you look smaller. No. You just gotta be big. Women on the other hand, they got all type of options. Mm-hmm. Didn't think we was gonna talk about y'all ass, huh? Mm-hmm. They ain't here. They're here right now with their little outfits on. What they do is they show you one outfit, and up underneath that bitch is another set of clothes, binding the ass up. Now, depending on how old she is, I'm going to tell you what she got on. If she 35 plus, she may have a garment on called the Spank. The Spank is amazing. It's made out of space shuttle and aluminum side. Got a little pee hole in there, a little pee hole. Because once your lady put that Spank on, dog, that's it for the whole day. You ever seen your lady put a Spank on? Let me tell you something. Do yourself a favor, fellas, and bust in on her. Putting that. I seen my wife about 2 weeks ago. We going out. She in the bathroom an hour. I'm like, what the fuck you doing? I bust in the door. She oiling up. She done squeezed oil. She putting her Spank on, sliding in. I'm like, did you just slide in your clothes? Now, if she don't have a Spank on, she may have another garment on called the Body Magic. Body Magic a little different. You know, Body Magic designed to correct a deficient area. You know, so wherever your lady got a problem, it'll take it and move it around. So your baby got a belly, right? She put that Body Magic on. Body Magic takes some of the belly, push it up here. The rest of the belly push it way down here. You be looking at your girl like, God damn. All right, baby girl, okay. Right? It'll make you forget. Me and my girl, we went out. She had the Body Magic on. We went out. We was having a good time. She was dancing. I was looking at her from the back. I was like, who the hell are you? We got home. I'm like, I'm about to tear this thing up tonight. She pulled that Body Magic off, looked like somebody opened a life raft in the room. I was pent up against the wall wheelchair.
The all-new MyLifeNewsNetwork.com with programming and news relevant to you. About us, for us, by us. MyLifeNewsNetwork.com.
Honestly, it is up to us to determine who actually has our best interests at heart. What we intend to do is to look out for our community with real issues and real thoughts. We want to be able to cover things that matter to our community. We want to be able to bring you this information without censure or without any form of restriction. We want to be the voice of our community and lead the charge for information that is disseminated throughout our masses.
Jenny Love, and I'm so excited to bring you a new shopping network. That's right, a new shopping network. It's called the Arkansas Shopping Network. Do you have a product or a service that you offer that needs exposure to the public? Well, you have it right here. Yes, right here, the Arkansas Shopping Network. That's it, the Arkansas Shopping Network. Let me and my crew showcase you. Let me tell you what you're gonna get with this amazing package that the Arkansas Shopping Network is gonna do for you. We're gonna come out, you're gonna get me, yes, me, to come out and I'll interview you and we'll talk about your amazing product that you want to get exposure to the public. Also, you'll get TV and radio commercial ads and promos. What an amazing deal you'll get and so much more. So let me and my crew showcase you. You can reach us at 855-525-5683. We can't wait to hear from you.
Identify the problem.
I'm straight. Be the solution.
The solution I am.
MyLifeAndTrustFoundation.org.
Hello, my name is Shay, and you're now watching My Life News Network.
I said they don't have, like, clothes for men. They actually have a, Body Magic has a shirt for men. Anybody know this? It's not true. I'm not making this up. Body Magic actually has a shirt for men. It's just a shirt, you know. Stop by right here. It ain't no leotard. Just a shirt. I wouldn't bought that damn shirt, brother. Got to feeling good about myself. I'm at the club. I start dancing around. What they don't tell you is you're not allowed to move what you once you put this shirt on. I put the shirt on, me and my lady on the dance floor got to getting it. I look up, this shirt just start riding up on my ass. Next thing I got a halter top on, trying to figure out why I feel like Beyonce. That's part of growing up, though. Your body change. I see young boys come to me all the time. Rod, you getting old. I say, yeah. You keep going to sleep and waking up, you'll be my age. Keep waking up another day. They don't know how good they got it, though, man. You see these young bucks? You know what I'm talking about, fellas? I seen this young buck the other day, 21 years old. Any young men here right now? 21, 22? I know you ain't just raised your goddamn hand. Just because you wearing that ball cap and them Jordans, you still 58, goddamn. He's like, this ain't even young. This. My son, 21. He don't respect nothing. He don't know how good he got at 21. Fellas, you remember 21? When your body was a steel trap? You 21 years old, everything your mind tell your body to do, it do. You 21, your mind said let's run. Your body like, fuck it, let's run. Not us. My mind said let's run. We got to have a meeting about this shit. Hold on. Why are we running, though? Ain't nobody chasing us, is it? Remember you used to be able to eat anything? Remember you was 18, 19, 20? It didn't matter. You just would go eat hot dogs, chicken wings, age. Not no more. The acid reflux is real, ain't it? You be mad if your man or woman let you eat that. She be like, how you let me eat this? Body change. I'm from Chicago. I love White Castle hamburgers. You might know what I'm talking about? It's a must-have when I go to Chicago. Only thing, I can't digest this shit no more. I'm in Chicago a month ago, went to White Castle, ate a White Castle, they shout the whole thing. I looked in the toilet, it was still in the box. Ketchup packets floating around this motherfucker, DJ. I said no ketchup. I want to thank anybody that's a part of a couple that's in this room right now. If you with somebody, again, let me hear y'all. If you with somebody you care about, yeah, it's okay. It's okay. I see this. It's coming. It's coming. Work on it. It's coming. I'm going to go even further. Fellas, if you in here with your woman, your significant other, I commend you even more. Because you a man. You here under duress. You didn't sign up for this bullshit. You just trying to fulfill an out night. I know. Men don't do that shit. We'd rather be at home. Somebody up in here right now, sleepy as fuck. Your ass had to work today. She been on your ass all week. We going, right? Don't say we going, we not going, because I'm going to get dressed. Yeah, we going. Ish. They like to be out, don't they? They so happy. Look at them. They so happy. They just like to be out. Women, look, I got proof. You with your lady. It's other women here that ain't with nobody, but they just out. Look at them. They so happy they out. This little group over here, look at them. They so, look at them. They high five. Oh, we out. You'll never catch five dudes like that. Dude, let's go out, my dog. What? We just going? I mean, yeah, just go out. Is it going to be just there? The only question we need answered. One thing I know, though, if you're here with your wife, this is what I know about you, and I don't know you. This is what I know about you. If you're here with your wife, you're here with the absolutely most beautiful, lovely, craziest chips in your life. Yes. Yes. Yeah, I know. Yeah. That's what you like, though. It took me a long time to figure this out. The crazier, the better, ain't it? I didn't know it. Yeah, you trying to sign up, ain't you? Yeah. Yeah, and she crazy as hell, too. I used to complain to one of my boys all the time. I said, man, my wife be doing this, she doing that. He said, Rod, you must like it. I get off and out of here. Maybe I'll love it. Because think about it, fellas. You're with your wife right now, but you had other women in your life. Wonderful women, beautiful, attractive, took all your bullshit, but they was too nice. You ain't want that bitch. You want the one you married, the crazy, if you bust out your window, scratch up your car, tell you your mama ain't shit, yeah. You like her? Yeah, you love her, but you hate her. I know. Mm-hmm. Like any of you ladies in here trying to close a deal? You wondering what the problem is? Why can't I close a deal? I mean, he loved me. I love him. How come it won't go to the next level? You ain't done nothing crazy enough. Oh, yeah. I'm going to try that. I'm going to help y'all tonight. Y'all next. I can tell y'all real close. I want you to try this next week. I know what you're saying to yourself, Rodney, but he right here. He a man. He's stupid. He's going to forget. I want you to hide by the front door. You're going to be coming home. You get off early, whatever you got to do, but you be there. When his key hit the door, I want you to run up and slap the shit out of that. Pop! Then run back over here and pull your pants down and wait. Now he's going to be mad as hell. He's going to come through the door like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Wait, what the? Okay. Okay. Don't do that shit no more, baby. Play too damn much, okay? Who laugh was that? Who did that? She laughed like she was in the color purple. Ha ha! Yeah. I need you to go on the road with me with that laugh. That's the best laugh of all time. He said, ha, ha. You laugh like a fat dude. Ride that pair of funny laugh. You like the crazy though? Like, you know what I stopped doing? I stopped blocking my phone. Stop blocking it. It took me a long time to figure this shit out, fellas. I'm going to help you tonight. First of all, they're going to break every code. It is not a code been made that they can't break. They just waiting on you to fuck up. She deep cover. She'll just wait. This is what you got to realize. Two things. First of all, I don't care how good your lady, how bad her vision is straight. her peripheral is 2020, nigga. She might be Stevie Wonder this way, but she'll go X-Man this way. Okay? They just be waiting on your ass to slip up in them numbers. I had got up to a 10-digit code, sir. I was trying like, no, this dude cannot continue to break these codes. I had 10 digits, but what you got to understand is they not getting numbers. They know you. So they know little stuff. They don't need but one number to crack the fucking code. I know, I see some of y'all looking like, really? Tell me, how she doing this shit? They don't need but one number. So imagine this. You laying in the bed, she kick in a super peripheral, boom, got him. A four, huh? That's all she saw, the four. She started going through your life for a four, a four, a four, a four, a four. Oh, his mama's birthday in April. Next thing you know, she under the bed the next day with your phone. Don't catch her. Don't catch her, because she really going to lose it. Hey, babe, what you doing? You make me do this. I was never this bitch. Sorry. Now you apologize for her going through show you.
Hi, this is Jenny Love, and I'm so excited to bring you a new shopping network. That's right, a new shopping network. It's called the Arkansas Shopping Network. Do you have a product or a service that you offer that needs exposure to the public? Well, you have it right here. Yes, right here, the Arkansas Shopping Network. That's it, the Arkansas Shopping Network. Let me and my crew showcase you. Let me tell you what you're going to get with this amazing package that the Arkansas Shopping Network is going to do for you. We're going to come out. You're going to get me, yes, me, to come out, and I'll interview you, and we'll talk about your amazing product that you want to get exposure to the public. Also, you'll get TV and radio commercial ads and promos. What an amazing deal you'll get, and so much more. So let me and my crew showcase you. You can reach us at 855-525-5683. We can't wait to hear from you.
Honestly, it is up to us to determine who actually has our best interests at heart. What we intend to do is to look out for our community with real issues and real thoughts. We want to be able to cover things that matter to our community. We want to be able to bring you this information without censure, without any form of restriction. We want to be the voice of our community and lead the charge for information that is disseminated throughout our masses.
Identify the problem.
I'm straight. Be the solution.
The solution I am.
MyLifeInTrustFoundation.org.
MyLifeNewsNetwork.com with programming and news relevant to you. About us, for us, by us. MyLifeNewsNetwork.com.
Hey, this is Sean Fresh. I'm here with Rodney Perry. Y'all are now watching My Life News Network. Is that what that's proper, right?
You said it right.
I think I did.
But you kind of stumbled across the end. You want to say it one more time?
Hey, what's going on, man? This is Sean Fresh. I'm here with Rodney Perry. You are now watching My News, what's the last?
My Life News Network.
My Life News Network.
Start over, said,
what is happening? More this your boy.
Oh,
hey, what's up, man?
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? This your boy, Sean Fresh, government
Perry,
name,
baby.
Rodney Perry. Now, what was that name?
My Life News Network.
You are now watching My Life News Network.
They can use that one.
Hey, can I, should I say that? I got to make it clean. God bless you.
You know how you in your mind, you be looking good? And then you pass a mirror and you're like, who is that? Like, I'm trying to start working out again. I done started working out a million times. I've come to one conclusion. No matter how much weight I lose or gain, I'm never going to lose this shit right here. Ain't no way to lose head weight. You understand me? Ain't no head ups. Once you get a fat head, that's going to be yours the rest of your life. You ever see people lose weight? Like Al Sharpton lost all that weight, but his head's still like a fat dude, right? And I don't know. I think he's sick. Is he sick? I think he done got a transplant. I think he put his head on another person's body. Can I, you know, we always complain as black people about Black History Month. Why we get the shortest month of the year. But there's some history to that. I'm not going to get into it, but look it up. It's the reason behind it. But there's little black history facts that we need to make ourselves privy to. You know, like I was just reading about Black Wall Street. Anybody familiar with Black Wall Street? It's known as the Black Holocaust. Over 1,500 people, black people killed in one day, 1821, sorry. That's one. This little tidbit I just learned, and it really blew me away. First of all, who believes we went to the moon in 1969? Nobody? I mean, y'all know what I'm talking about. We went to the moon, Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin. But what you don't know is that there was a black man on that mission. That's right. Rodney Perry here to educate y'all tonight as well as tickle your funny bone. Hold on, ma'am. I'm having a moment up here, okay? There was a black man on a mission to the moon. It was Buzz Aldrin, Neil Armstrong, and a guy by the name of Donnell Jenkins. Donnell was a photographer. Donnell's sole purpose on the mission to the moon was to get footage of Neil Armstrong being the first man to step foot on the moon. They get to the moon, they got the flight, they get to the moon, Buzz Aldrin turned to Donnell and said, Donnell, go outside, set your shit up, so we can have footage of Neil Armstrong being the first man to step foot on the moon. Little did they realize that by sending Donnell outside, Donnell was actually the first man to step foot on the moon. Shouts out to Donnell Rock. Donnell Jenkins, yes. Immediately they realized it. They were like, oh, shit. Donnell, the first man to step foot on the moon. Buzz, I'll just say, don't worry about it, you know. You just gonna walk out there. And y'all seen the footage, one small step for mankind, one giant step. That's where it gets sad. You know they left Donnell's ass up there? I know what you're saying. They said, Rodney Perry, stop playing. Why you want to make up their shit up like that? Mm-mm. I got proof. I got proof, ma'am, and your voice carries. You must be in a little acoustic window and shit. You ever been watching MTV? Hmm? You ever see the little moon man standing next to the flag? That's Donnell, y'all. Get Donnell some love, man. Come back, brother. That was the best. Thank you. You just superseded her bullshit laugh. That was great. I'm joking, ma'am. Your titties look incredible. Thank you. I got a couple of things don't have nothing to do with nothing, but it's just some thoughts I have. So I'm going to throw them out there. First of all, I had them turn the lights up because I wanted to see y'all. And I'm going to be honest, ma'am, and I know you're sleepy as hell right now. We almost done, okay? You like, please hurry up.
I can see you. Please don't go to sleep. Help my self-esteem. Okay.
I'm looking at y'all, and I'm going to tell y'all right now, y'all 90% good looking. Like, as a group, this is might be one of the best looking groups I've ever seen. This is good. You know what I'm saying? Get out the hand. I'm going to go even further. I'm going to say most people are good looking. Most people are good looking. Like, sir, you're an attractive man, ma'am with the little highlights. That's beautiful. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Lucius Lyon. Killing these little bums, ain't you? Most people are attractive. If that's true, then what does that mean? That means that the ugly people are the truly special people. Because it's not as many of them. Okay? I think God gives us ugly people to see how compassionate we could be. I believe this. Y'all tell me what y'all think. I think God duplicates the good-looking faces. How many times have you seen somebody, you'd be like, you know what? She looked just like somebody I seen, blah, blah, blah. Like, ma'am, you know, I'm looking at you, you're gorgeous. I know for a fact I've seen your face eight or nine times in my life. All over the world. Your face is in global rotation. Now, if that's true, let's all take a mental look into your own personal Rolodex. And let's find the ugliest of them that you know. Now, have you seen that twice? You ain't seen no Flavor Flav. You ain't seen that friggin' from the basketball show with a knot on his head. You ain't seen him again. I'm going to take it even one step further. I'm going to tell you fellas something. If any single men in here, you trying to figure out who to spend your life with, forget these pretty girls. I know y'all want a pretty woman, think you're going to procreate, fix your deficiencies. That ain't the way to do it. You got to get the ugliest woman you can find. Stay with me on this, okay? Because it's simple mathematics. Okay, let me find somebody. I'm going to use you, sir. This is hypothetical. I know you got a beautiful lady in your life. But you a handsome man, right? You handsome. I mean, I ain't hitting on you or nothing, but you handsome. I'm saying you get an ugly woman, okay? You handsome. She handsome. You double your chance of having a handsome child. A boy. Okay? Now, I know what you're saying. I know you're saying Rodney Perry, but what if I have a girl? No. Ugly women only make boys. Think about it. Look at all your little ugly friends. They all got four or five boys. They're like right there. Boom, boom, boom. Okay? Your ugly friend got boys, am I right? Y'all don't have to say nothing. Is she here? Is she here? This don't have nothing to do with nothing. I'm looking at y'all. Another thing, my job is to notice things. Okay. Y'all, most of y'all got straight eyes. Straight at it. Kind of a lazy eye, but still straight at it. You know what I'm talking about. Most people straight at it. Okay. So what does that mean? That means the cockeyed people are the truly special people in this world. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling y'all something to help you. When you find somebody cockeyed, especially my white friends, like, ma'am, how many times have you seen a cockeyed person in your life? 3 or 4 times. How many white ones? Let me tell you something. If you see a white cockeyed person or a Mexican, you better go buy a fucking lottery ticket. That's your fucking lucky day. You understand me? Like right now, sir, you straight at it. You here with your lovely wife. Y'all look beautiful together. Guess what you can't do because you straight at it. If a beautiful woman come past, you can't look. But if you was cockeyed, she wouldn't know what the fuck you was looking at. Hardest part about doing that joke, right, is inevitably, while I'm doing it, you see somebody that's cockeyed. They be looking at your ass like, really, nigga? But you don't know if they looking at you, so you just keep going.
The all-new MyLifeNewsNetwork.com with programming and news relevant to you. About us, for us, by us. MyLifeNewsNetwork.com.
Identify the problem.
I'm straight. Be the solution.
The solution I am.
MyLifeAndTrustFoundation.org.
Honestly, it is up to us to determine who actually has our best interests at heart. What we intend to do is to look out for our community with real issues and real thoughts. We want to be able to cover things that matter to our community. We want to be able to bring you this information without censure or without any form of restriction. We want to be the voice of our community and lead the charge for information that is disseminated throughout our masses.
Hi, this is Jenny Love, and I'm so excited to bring you a new shopping network. That's right, a new shopping network. It's called the Arkansas Shopping Network. Do you have a product or a service that you offer that needs exposure to the public? Well, you have it right here. Yes, right here, the Arkansas Shopping Network. That's it, the Arkansas Shopping Network. Let me and my crew showcase you. Let me tell you what you're going to get with this amazing package that the Arkansas Shopping Network is going to do for you. We're going to come out. You're going to get me, yes, me, to come out and I'll interview you and we'll talk about your amazing product that you want to get exposure to the public. Also, you'll get TV and radio commercial ads and promos. What an amazing deal you'll get and so much more. So let me and my crew showcase you. You can reach us at 855-525-5683. We can't wait to hear from you.